As state and county officials weigh what to restrict and where the most risky locations are, we wanted to know what data they're using to decide. Gina Mangieri is always investigating and found out what is and what is not tracked by the numbers.
Everyone from the public to lawmakers, to scientists, to doctors watching COVID trends are clamoring for health officials to release more kinds of COVID data in Hawaii. The Department of Health says more is coming. But I dug into what they may already know that could help inform better public policy. The governor and Honolulu's mayor say they're taking a targeted approach with the latest restrictions, avoiding mass shutdowns or categorical closings.
We do believe and know that these additional restrictions can further help stop and slow the spread of COVID-19 here on Oahu.
But how do they, or we, really know, beyond the anecdotal disclosures about individual cases or clusters, what is proving to be the more risky areas? I obtained the COVID case forms and state database templates to dig into how health officials are gathering information about positive COVID cases. From this, we can see what could be accessible to policymakers in order to know the areas that are really proving to be the most risky sites for the virus. It is set up with specific variables for race and age, and also whether there's been recent travel or a household transmission. But beyond that, there are no specific categories on the intake forms to help sort place of exposure into the 17 location-specific categories that Hawaii's reopening plan says it's watching for risk. It would not easily output, for example, exactly how many positives have come from the beach or the bar, the gym or the office.
I do think the general categories of the clusters would be a valuable piece of information. And especially since this disease is a super spreading disease, so clusters really, really matter.
That's Dr. Victoria Fan, a UH Manoa social scientist who's part of the Hawaii Pandemic Applied Modeling Work Group, HIPAM for short. HIPAM's worst case model as of this summer came more than true in late July, and their forecast into August warns of a 10,000 to 12,000 case range within weeks if something drastic does not change.
With HIPAM, we've been advocating for getting more real-time, granular data. We've been communicating with and trying to work with the Department of Health in terms of improving their data systems.
So have Hawaii lawmakers, the State House imploring health officials to share more details regularly about when and especially where COVID pops up. Some of those wishes are about to come true.
We have new metrics that we are going to be publishing, including the response time for case investigations and contact tracing, as well as lab turnaround times.
Lots of data already exists on the state dashboard, and just Tuesday, the state released an aggregated list of previously announced cases and say they'll keep doing that weekly. Data experts offer a lesson on a key variable called R-naught, the level of infectiousness and the number of people each case spreads COVID to on average. Hawaii's R-naught has been really high, making for a steep exponential curve.
While I think it's really important that you know, we use data to make informed decisions, so much of this epidemic is really in our own hands, and it's in the hands of everyday people. Our actions, such as putting on our face masks and washing our hands and staying apart, staying at home, you know, that will help to drive that rate of transmission down.
Links to the state data and HIPAM forecasts are on our website, along with that new weekly case and cluster compilation. Gina Mangieri, KHON2 News, always investigating.